Today in the B Block, American athletes and Chinese justice. It was nearly 8 months ago that three UCLA freshman basketball players, including LiAngelo Ball, were detained for 6 days in China after being apprehended shoplifting from several high-end stores in the city of Hangzhou. The players' case attracted international headlines, the attention of the U.S. government, including that of President Trump. Now, by contrast, the case of Wendell Brown is very different. Virtually no one knows of this former Ball State and CFL football player. He was arrested in a bar fight in Chongqing 20 months ago. Brown has been in jail ever since, still awaiting a verdict from his trial, which was last year. Filmmaker and documentarian Matt Liston has taken up the cause in the case of his fellow Ball State alum. Matt, it's good to have you here.
Hi, thanks, Bob.
Wendell, what was he doing? Why was he living in China?
Well, Wendell was in China teaching American football. He was coaching older players how to play the game, as well as volunteering to teach children how to play American football.
So over there doing that. He's been, as we said, since the summer of 2016. He had his trial last year. You have been corresponding with him as these cases, some would say languished or others would say progressed with the Chinese system. What has he revealed to you about his character and his attitude about this?
Well, I'll tell you what, you know, we're allowed to exchange letters with him through the U.S. consulate once a month. And one thing that is very clear is his spiritual strength through this. You know, he misses his family. He loves his family and friends. And he wants to be home. But at the same time, he has such great spiritual strength through this. And I want to add that he also has a sense of humor. And it comes through, despite what he's going through right now, he likes to make some jokes here or there in the letters. And I think that's great during a time like this because I think it boosts the morale of his family and friends who are anxiously awaiting his return.
Yeah, we have some of the pictures up that show him working with some of the Chinese youth. I know in an interview he was asked, what's the best thing about China? He said, the people. So he was working hand-to-hand with the young folks and coaching football. He and his family, or his family and friends here in the States, though, have taken up his case. They went to Washington. What happened?
Well, yes, they went to Washington back in March. Wendell's family actually rented a couple of vans, loaded themselves in these vans, and drove through the night from Detroit to Washington, D.C. for meetings that were to take place the very next morning. Well, they arrived at 9 a.m. for their 9:30 meetings, and they never happened. Unfortunately, they were all canceled, all three of them. And despite it being a heartbreaking moment, it speaks to the strength of Wendell's family because they persevered, they moved on, and now they've gotten enough attention on this cause and this case to make it a little bit more high profile. And to be honest with you, we are thrilled to announce that the government, both the Chinese government and the United States government, have been working together on this case. Both the White House and the State Department have stepped up, and they're working tirelessly to bring Wendell Brown home.
Because at this point, according to the strict reading of the law, he faces possibly 3 to 10 years, does he not?
That's correct. That's correct. Now, we will learn his verdict on late Wednesday night. I'll be with Wendell's family in Detroit. We'll be praying together. And what we're looking for is, while they have a 99% conviction rate in the Chinese courts, what we're hoping to hear is the news that there are many scenarios that can play out that allow for an immediate release, where Wendell can come home to his family. And that's what we'll be waiting for and praying for that phone call.
And I know you've got a website, bringhomewb.com, in which a lot of these facts are out there. 20 months, and as far as his family said, there's never been a moment when he's doubted that something good will happen at the end here.
That's right. By the way, 20 months and not convicted of any crime. It's unbelievable. And yet he stays spiritually strong, and I think a lot of that comes from his mother, who is the heart and soul of this campaign, and she's his eyes and ears. And we believe Wendell Brown will return home.